Hello, I'm Mike from SurgTech Academy, and today I'm going to demonstrate the surgical hand scrub. The surgical hand scrub is performed after we've opened supplies and before we gown and glove. We scrub our hands so that we lower the risk of hospital-acquired infections by reducing the number of transient and resident flora. Now, although we can't consider our hands sterile after a surgical hand scrub, we can call them surgically clean. Now, there are three methods of getting our hands surgically clean. These methods are the time method. The old school method was 5 minutes, but new research has shown that 3 to 4 minutes of scrubbing is just as effective with less cell damage and less cell shedding to our skin. Then we have the counted brush or the stroke method, of which I'm going to demonstrate here. And then lastly, we have the waterless or brushless method that I've already shown in a previous video. Next, I want to talk about some antiseptic agents. In our lab, we use 3% PCMX, which is chlorhexidine. We use 4% CHG, chlorhexidigluconate. And then we have good old-fashioned povidone iodine. I still love that stuff for those students that have skin sensitivity issues. Now, there are some key ideas that I want you to remember for the surgical hand scrub. One, we scrub our fingertips to 2 inches above the elbow. We make sure to keep our fingertips always above our elbow. We scrub all 4 anatomical planes, and we avoid contact with any non-sterile surface, such as the sink head or the sink itself. Now make sure you follow hospital policy as to which method your hospital uses. So I have my personal protective equipment on, and I've already opened. My scrub top is short. Now, if your scrub top has to be longer, you can roll your scrub top, you can tuck it under your bra strap, whatever you have to do so that you can get 2 inches above your elbow. All right, next I'm going to demonstrate. I'm going to assemble my package and I'm going to open my package. I like to keep the nail pick and the brush in the same hand. I'm going to turn on the water. You can adjust the level of water and you can adjust the temperature. I think it's fine where it's at. I'm going to get my hands wet. Next, I'm going to take the nail pick and dig underneath my nails under running water. Next, I'm going to work up a little lather and turn off the water. Water conservation is always good, isn't it? Should be a key to any hospital or any operating room. So next, I'm going to scrub both sets of nails for 30 strokes each. One stroke is back and forth. I do both sets of hands first. I have found that students tend to, if they do one set of nails in the arm, they tend to forget the second set of nails for some reason. So I do both sets of nails at the same time, 30 strokes. Then we can actually take off the brush so that we just have the sponge left. I found this is good for a couple of reasons. All right, one, using the brush on any part of our skin actually, again, increases cell shedding. So my students tend to remove the brush, and the sponge is a lot more flexible and is good for getting into webbing. So we tend to do that. Next, I'm going to divide each finger into 4 planes and scrub each plane 10 times. At this point, I also want to get the webbing 10 times. Notice that I have actually moved away from the sink at a 45 degree angle. This helps make sure that I don't accidentally touch the sink head. And also notice that my fingertips are always above my elbow, and all I am doing is rotating my arm on an axis. Next, we do every section of our hand. Back of the hand, side of the hand, palm of the hand, and the other side of the hand. And again, we do this 10 times. After we've done our hand, then we're going to do our arm. Basically, we divide our arm into three different sections, and you guessed it, we scrub each section 10 times. Now, never do this, but just to give you an idea of how wide we have to scrub, if I take my sponge and do it three different times, three different sections, I'm going to get within 2 inches above the elbow. So our circles don't have to be that big. All right, I'm gonna switch hands. At any time we can add more soap or more water to our sponge. I'm gonna add a little water. We've already done our nails, so we can go straight to the thumb. Webbing. Onto our hand, also 10 circles. Now to our arm. It should be noted that if at any time I drop my sponge, there's a couple things I can do. All right, one, if my circulator's around, I can have my circulator grab me a new sponge. Or two, I can rinse my arms and completely start over. Now at this point, we can throw our sponge into a waste receptacle, or we can throw it down in the sink. I'm going to throw it down in the sink. Now rinsing the arms. We want to rinse from our fingers to our elbows in an upward motion. Sometimes I tell my students, it's like giving an uppercut to somebody. So no back and forth, one fluid motion. That's it. At this point, I would back into the operating room with my hip, making sure that my fingers are always above my elbows and from my shoulders to my axilla. So that's it. A very basic and crucial skill in our days in surgery, and also a skill that I've seen many practitioners become a bit lazy with. So from Mike at SurgTech Academy, I'm wishing you a good day in surgery, and reminding you to be a superstar in the OR!